All right now, you are welcome, and I'm very sorry because there are a lot of circumstances that is getting this. That is why I have not started the class with you now. All right, but I want to now we are starting. When you are, like I told you, you're going to use your WPS since you don't have your system now. You're going to use your WPS, but this one is just an introduction, so for you to know how it works and how to really work with Microsoft Word. So that is exactly what you are doing. And of course, you have started Microsoft Word already, and you have learned some things in it. But now I want to rephrase it. I want to rephrase Microsoft Word now. So what you need to do is to listen attentively and learn better, and also follow the processes I'm going to show you now. The process I'm going to show you, follow it one by one, step by step. Alright, so the very first thing now is to launch Microsoft Word. How do you do that now? Click on Start. When you click on Start, then if you cannot find your Microsoft Word around here, and of course I can see it on the taskbar. So like this place now is called taskbar. So I can see it on the taskbar, but so this is it now on the taskbar. So another thing you need to do is to, if you can't find it on the taskbar here, then go ahead to all programs, start menu on the taskbar. So when you click on start menu, click on all programs. So when you click on all programs, then locate your Microsoft Word. So in now this is 2016, so in your system you might be using any other version, but once you are using WPS, so you don't have much problem. Just launch your WPS and go straight to the Microsoft Word. All right, so now I'm going to launch Word. All right, this is Vision. I'm very sorry for that. Let me launch my Word here. So I click on Word. This is Visual 2016. So I'm going to launch my, I'm going to close this one, then I will launch Word 2016. All right, so it's launching. We have to wait a while for it to finish launching. All right, so this is Word. So I click on a blank document. So when you click on blank document, you are going to see the blank environment. So from the blank environment, let me increase the view. I want to increase the page size, but not really the size, is the zoom. I want to increase the zoom so that I can see clearly. So come to the zoom area here. So zoom it. Then from there you can, and as well you can click on minus here, or you click on a plus here. Minus here will zoom out. Then plus here will zoom in. So I'll zoom it in now. Alright, now the very first thing we're going to do here now is something simple that can enable you to do something on WPS, and that is exactly what we're going to do now. Alright, so the very first thing you're going to do is how to typeset application letter. How to typeset application letter. Of course, you can type, and there are so many things you can do when it comes to typing. But there is a procedure and there is a guideline for typing and for creating professional documents. Just like I told you, I said there is features of word processing. So in order to produce a standard document that meets up with the standard organization, so there is need for you to, you know, to undergo the following four features of word processing. So now, to say that, what is word processing? Word processing is the art of typesetting documents, setting such documents, editing such documents, and formatting such documents. Now, I will now say what are the features of word processing. Features of word processing are typesetting, setting, editing, and formatting. And that is what we want to do here now. So, for instance, now we want to typeset application letter. So the very first thing you need to do here now is to type your own address. So let's say, for instance, my address is 12 Badering Street, Mafolukwu, Oshodi. Then I'll press comma, then I'll press enter key to take me to the next line. Then Mafolukwu, Oshodi. Then I'm going to bring it here. Mafolukwu. Then I press enter key once. Then I say Oshodi Lagos. Then full stop. Now and press enter key. Sorry, there's a mistake there. So I can use my arrow key to go back to the where there's a mistake and press my backspace to delete it. So I use my arrow key to move. So I can use my up arrow key to move up, down arrow key to move down, and left arrow key to move left, and right arrow key to move right. Right arrow key to move right. So push your Lagos. Then I type the date. Like, for instance, now today's date. Today's date 10/10/10. So I say 10th of October. 10th of October 2020. So now you press enter key twice. When you press enter key twice, now it will take you to the next paragraph. In order to create paragraph, you have to press enter key twice. Then I'm going to write my recipient address. Mind you, what you are typing is application letter, so I'm trying to give you the format of application letter. And you see this this address, your home address, your contact address, is going to be at the right. So we have to do the setting later. Remember, type setting, editing, formatting. So what we are doing now is this type setting. We have not done the remaining features of word processing. We are doing the first part of the word features of word processing, which is type setting. So right now, we will take the recipient number. So let's assume you want to follow this application letter to ZTech looking for a job. So for example, you want to apply for a post of a secretary. So this is the content you're going to type. All right, here now I'm going to say make sure the initial letter is always capital letter. The managing director. Then press enter key. Then write the name of the organization. For example, ZTech Computer Institute. The name of the organization. Then press enter key. Then now type the address. If you know the address, if not, leave it. So this is application letter. So we call it cover letter for tertiary, for advanced workers. We call it a cover letter. So now, right now, I'm going to type the address. So the address is going to be 20 Oyegua Street, Oyegua Street, then Ladipo Estate, Oshodi. Oh, let me bring it. Okay, I can leave it like that. Ladipo Estate, Oshodi, Lagos. All right. So now I'm going to make initial letter, capital letter, every word in this case now, because it's an address. So I'm going to make the initial letter to be capital letter. So now press enter key to have a paragraph. So now in this case, now I'm going to say dear sir or ma, then comma. Then I'm going to type in capital letter now, application for an employment. Now press enter key. Now in this case, you are supposed to press enter key twice to create a paragraph. Now just press enter key once here now. Then see, I hereby apply for the vacant post as a secretary in your reputable organization. So that is what I'm going to type now. In your reputable organization, which was which was introduced to me, so that's what I'm going to type. I hope you are getting me. So you just have to follow the process. The process I'm giving to you now, you just have to follow the process. Yes, Ada. You just have to follow the process. The process I'm giving to you now. So you said, and I said, which was introduced to me through a friend. You can say, you can just tell the person that anyhow, through a friend currently working in your organization. Then full stop. Enter key twice to create another paragraph. That is exactly what you are going to do. You are going to press enter key twice. Anytime you want to create a paragraph, you must press enter key twice. So if you are not pressing enter key twice, if you just press enter key once, that means you are writing, you are typing on the same line, on another line. You are not creating paragraph. So anytime you want to create a paragraph, you must create enter key. You must press enter key twice to create a paragraph. All right. So you can now say, I am a young man of 28 years old. Old, comma, dark in complexion, and ale from Abeokuta North. Ogun State. Full stop. Then enter key twice to create another paragraph. So if there's any correction, that is why editing is important. So if there's any part that is not correct, I'm going to edit it later, because editing is part of the features of word processing. All right. I'm currently processing words now. So now I can now say, I attended Oshodi High, for example, Oshodi High School, Oshodi, Lagos. Where I got my outstanding, result. Full stop. I mean, not have to type much, and you can type much. You know, just as it comes through your mind. You know, this one is just a format. So press it back twice. Then just say attached here with the copies. Of my credentials and other documents to be used to as your perusal, to be used as your perusal. All right, full stop. Then enter key twice to create another paragraph. Then say, I will be so glad if my application can be taken into consideration. Full stop. Say back it twice. They say thanks in anticipation to hearing from you. So thanks in anticipation. Do it this way, write this one. In anticipation to receiving. Thanks in association to receiving a positive response from your reputable organization. From your reputable organization. Then type here paragraph. Yours faithfully. Exactly twice. Your name. Your name will be here now. Oh, sorry. Yours faithfully, and you say Charles O. Adewale. Don't mind this. So it's because of the spaces are too much. So since it's jumping to the next line, and you want it to remain in the same page, it's jumping to another page, and you want it to remain in the same page, in one single page. So what you need to do, you can see now if you check here, you discover that it's page 2 of 2. Me, and as it is now, it has jumped to the second page, and I still want it to remain in the same page. So what you do now is to press Ctrl A to highlight all. Then it has been highlighted. So everything has been highlighted. So right click on it, then click on paragraph. Click on paragraph, then click on don't add space between paragraph or the same style. Then come here is zero under spacing. Here is zero. Here is 0 point. Then here after, make it 0.2. Then come here, choose single. Then click on OK. You see that everything will jump to one page. Look at it now. Everything has jumped to one page. So it means that you still have more space to type. You see? You still have more space. But right now, it's too squeezed to each other. It's too squeezed. So what I will do, I will now press Control 5 to give it 1.5 line spacing. So now, I've given it Control 5 now. So it's not space now. So you can see, so that's exactly what you're going to do. All right, so now, yours is really, Chiasua Adewale, then you put your number there, so in case they want to call you, that is 00, 36, for example, 08, that is 094. So this is for example. Now, another thing you need to do here now is to edit, to set. How do you set? So select this, your own address. You can see how I selected this. I click and drag over. Then I can click and drag over like this. I make sure my cursor is placing here. You can see my cursor blinking here. So as my cursor is blinking there, I will click there and drag down. to select. All right, now I'll use from to increase indent. You can see under your home, you see decrease indent and you see increase indent. So use the increase indent to move. Use the increase indent to move. Now I have moved that way. Now this one will remain that way and this one will remain that way. So I can select it like this and say bold here, italicize, shortcut, Control B to bold, Control I to for italics. Then this one is capital letter, so I don't need to underline it. I only set it to the center. So I will say align center here. You can see center alignment. Then you can say Control B to bold. And the, for the center alignment, the shortcut is Control E to align center. Control E to align center. That is the shortcut. All right, you can see the setting. So the setting is getting mature. It's getting mature. So now, another thing you need to do here now is to edit. After you have done the settings, another thing you need to do here now is to edit. You're not going to underline this one because it's a capital letter. But I mean it's a small letter, we are going to underline it. All right, now let's edit. Which area is not correct here? As you can see, most of these things are not correct. And though they are correct, but because most of them are Yoruba language, and the computer does not understand Yoruba, and there are some languages that computer may not understand, so they are correct, but the computer will still underline it red. That means it's not correct. So now what you need to do is to ignore. Let's click on it and say what? Ignore all. So now, if I want to do this, I'll say right click, ignore all. But will I have to continue like that? No. So in that case, you can use the shortcut. The shortcut is F7. Just press F7. It will take you to spelling and grammar check. As you can see at your right corner, spelling and grammar check. So what you need to do now is, it has suggested it to see you say this is the spelling. Oyegunwa. Is that what you want? Is there any suggestion that can replace Oyegunwa here? No suggestion. So in that case, say ignore all. Then Ladipo. Is there any suggestion here that can replace Ladipo? It's correct. That is what we want. So say ignore. So Oshodi. Is there any suggestion here that can replace Oshodi? No. So in that case, say ignore all. There. Is there any suggestion here that can replace there? Now, it's supposed to be there. I can see dick. So you see now, since it's, there's no suggestion there, come down here and change it. And change it there. Or you right click. Okay, there's no suggestion there. So delete it and replace it with the there. So then you have it like that. Now, okay, we wanted to say dark. Oh, sorry, it's even dark. You know, there was a suggestion. So let me undo. Okay, we wanted to say dark. Okay, is there a suggestion here that can replace dark? You can see this is exactly what we wanted to choose. So this is the suggestion. So once you choose the suggestion that can replace this thing, then instead of it to say ignore, you don't say ignore. Because if you say ignore, it means you should not do anything with it. It means nothing should be changed. That is it. That means you are telling the computer that it's very, very correct. It's very much correct. But in this case now, what we are expecting here is not correct. We are expecting dark and it's writing day. So in that case, what you need to do is to choose this dark, the correct option, and click on change. So it has changed. Then Oshodi, we still mean the same thing. So in that case, we are going to say ignore her. Now Adewale is correct, but it's telling me because it's a Yoruba name, it's telling me it's not correct. So I'm going to say ignore. Now in this case now, it's going to write spelling and grammar check complete. Spelling and grammar check is complete. That means your stuff is not very neat now. So everything is neat because it can cross-check everything and it's very much correct now. Let me pull this one and italicize this one. As you can see, if I don't want to go here, I can at the same time select like this and do it here. That is if I don't want to go to the menu bar. All right, so I've done that. Now another thing you need to do now is to, you can just beautify it more. You can beautify it more by coming to because this is an advanced application letter, not like regular application letter you used to know. So this advanced application letter, you can just go to design. Under design, that is here in design, but in your WPS it might be insert. You might have to go to insert to get this page color. to get the page color. So I'm giving it this light page color, then page border. Then when you click on page border like that, here to, if you click, choose box. When you choose box, come here and choose the color for the page border. For example, now I'm choosing blue. So as I choose blue, now I want it to be more thicker. I will come here and choose the thicker, the thickness. You see the width. I choose 6 width, 6 point width. Then I click on OK. Then you have it this way now. As you can see, so this is a professional application letter. So this is a professional application letter. So you have it like this. So now another thing, another last thing you need to do now is to, because this time now. You don't, in like I told you, I said this can also be called cover letter for advanced people, advanced worker, advanced employees or employers. It is called cover letter. So it's in a secondary level that you call it application letter. So it's not it can be called application letter anyway, and it can also be called cover letter. So this is an advanced one. So you may want to send it electronically, because these days now people don't really collect application letter as hard copy anymore. They collect it as soft copy. So application document like your CV, your result, your certificate, anything. So these days now they used to tell you send it through email or send it to me on WhatsApp or send it to me on Messenger. So that is, people are now using the use of internet, the features of internet now to achieve this. So you may not have to print it out. You may want to send it through those channels I just mentioned earlier, through electronics, or you may want to send it electronically. So if you want to send it through any of these channels, that means you will not print it out. So if you are not printing it out, there's need for you to put signature here then. So in that case, how do you insert the signature? Go to insert, then click on shapes, then in your shapes, choose free form. So when you choose free form, then just begin to construct. So let's assume I'm accepting this as my signature. So what I will need to do now is to come to shape and choose color for it. So come to shape and choose color. So I'm choosing this color now. So that is my signature. As you can see, you can place it where you want to place it. That is it. I hope you understand. So this will be the head of the class. This is just it is starting point. There are still much to learn, and electronically you're going to learn more. As in through on our online training, you're going to learn more and learn better. This is very, very much better. Like I told you, to carry out this, you can either use your WPS on your phone to do this, or you can also, if you don't have much of the features, there might be a need for you to subscribe to the premium features of WPS. But better still, you can also use the basic premium, basic features. The basic features you can see used to achieve this, because this is not too advanced. So this application letter is just for basic. It's for the beginners. So, and the content written here are just a format. You can construct your own format. You can advance this format. The content, what I wrote here, you can advance it. You can get more of it. You understand that now? You can advance it. You can put it to your taste. You can do it the way you want it to be, according to your own information, according to the company or the organization you want to send it to. Like I told you, this one is like a cover letter, and it's also called application letter. So that is exactly so what it is. So thank you so much. God bless you. If you follow me, you will not regret it.